Hello everyone, my name is Carol, for those who don't know me. I relay messages and words of encouragement from the Lord and through the Holy Spirit. So today, as the title says, I just received the caption for this video to be "What the Lord Spoke to Me About Moses," about the story of Moses. So the Lord speaks through many ways, and one of the most times that he speaks is through his word. So the Lord was speaking to me through the story of Moses. I had never really heard the story of Moses like this before. There were things that I never really knew about the story of Moses. So when the Lord showed me this, I was shocked because I had never heard it before. So I received a word from the Lord on Sunday, which is the 23rd of July. I was busy doing my bed, and the story was actually playing on my phone, and I was listening to the whole story as it played. So, as we all know, that Moses was in a basket and was found by Pharaoh's daughter. So, if you have your Bibles with you, or whenever you're done watching this video, if you get the chance, I would advise you to go and read the second book of Moses, which is called Exodus, from the first chapter, from verse 15 up until the second. So, Moses 1 and 2, I would advise you to read. So, basically, at this time when Moses was born, Joseph had already died, and a new king reigned, and the new king did not know Joseph. So the new king saw that the children of Israel were greater than they were in the kingdom, so they wanted to make sure that the children of Israel there's not any more. So he tried to cut that by saying that every male child who gets born from the children of Israel must die. So he spoke to the midwives. So Moses' mother kept Moses in hiding, and she kept him for 3 months. When she saw that she could not keep him anymore, she had to let him go, and she put him in a basket. What really triggered me and blessed me about this message was the fact that she trusted God. Imagine, as a mother, putting your child in a basket. Your child is 3 months. Trusting God that much and letting your child go, not knowing what's going to happen to your child, but letting your child go and just obeying and trusting in the Lord to take care of your child. So she did that. She put the child in the basket and she let the child go into the river. Lo and behold, at the same time, talk about God's timing, talk about God's alignment, talk about being obedient. At the same time, Pharaoh's daughter was bathing in the river, and they saw the basket, the child's basket. Now Moses had a sister, and the sister followed the basket to see what would happen. So when Pharaoh's daughter saw the basket, she opened it and she saw a baby, and she was just overwhelmed with compassion from the Lord. And she was just compelled and led to just take the baby and take care of that child. So Moses' sister said, why don't I now go and find a nurse who is a Hebrew, the same as the child, because Moses is a Hebrew, who will look after the child for you? So she's like, yes, go and find me a nurse. So who does she call? Her mother. She calls her mother, the child's mother. And the child went back to his mother. Moses went back and was raised by his mother. And Pharaoh's daughter paid wages. So what the Lord was saying to me, and I, you know, maybe this word is for someone specific. What the Lord was saying to me in this is that we have entered into a season of completion where things that he has promised you have come to completion. And that just like Moses' mother, he just needs you to trust him and let it go. Even if it's a very difficult thing, a difficult situation, whatever he's promised you, whatever you know that God is doing in your life, he will complete it. Just like he did with Moses. His mother let the baby go, only to bring the baby back to her to raise. So God will do it for you in this season of completion. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and he will come through for you. And I was in the secret place when I was, you know, just going over this story, because it was also a personal revelation for me. It was a personal word for me from the Lord, but he did reveal that I should share it with you, that it is completion season. It is finished. When God finished it on the cross, it is finished. There's no turning back. There's no turning back. It doesn't need to be redone. It's not going to be redone. And the Lord is saying to somebody today that it is finished. You're out of that season, that wilderness. You're into completion, where God is completing everything, is finishing everything to move you into that next glory, because we move from glory to glory. I really pray that this message has blessed somebody today, and I really pray that you take the time to go and read the book of Exodus, the second book of Moses, Exodus 1 and 2, and pray about it and speak to the Lord about it if this word is for you. Thank you so much. God bless you all.
God of Abraham, take my child into thy hands, that he may live to thy service.
But mother, we have not even given him a name.
God will give him a name. Follow it, Miriam. Watch it from the reeds.
And you will serve him as you serve me. Fill the ark with water. Sink it into silence. Raise your hands, Memnet. What you have buried in the Nile shall remain buried in your heart. Swear it.
I will be silent.
The day you break that oath will be the last your eyes shall ever see. You will be the glory of Egypt, my son. mighty in words and deeds. Kings shall bow before you. Your name will live when the pyramids are dust. And because I drew you from the water, you shall be called Moses.